Hey, it's George. This is going to be a just a recent listens. Hold on, let me take this off. Wait, hold on. There's a solo, actually. Is it coming up? There's a really good solo. Come on. Yeah. I think it's good. Anyway, that's this Chocolate Watch Band single I got that I've been playing a lot. Oh, wait. There's another little... Yeah, sorry. This is great. This is a single I got recently. Local store got it in. I guess it was released for Record Store Day 2012. I got it for cheaper than it was on a Record Store Day 2012. And I've been listening to this thing over and over. They did a cover of In the Midnight Hour on their first album. But it's with a different singer. So this is a different version. And then you get, the B-side is an instrumental called Psychedelic Trip, which is just a really, really good instrumental. But, yeah, there's still some really good, you know, deals out there. This was really cheap. There's this guy that I've been watching, younger guy like me, and, I think it's Soren Vinyl, and, he's been showing some, like, he found a Electric Prunes album in the dollar bin, and he, I don't know, I'm still holding this up, and, that Stones Live album from the 60s in the dollar bin. It's like, wow, I'm not getting that crazy deals, but this is pretty cheap, so yeah, Chocolate Watch Band, let me take this off for real. Anyway, it's on, Sundazed, really, really, really awesome single. If you can find this, jump on it. It's really, really good. And like I said, the B-side, the instrumental is really good too. And so like I said, this is just going to be a recent listens. I'm kind of, I don't really have any ideas for videos other than vinyl finds in this. So I'm, you know, if you have any ideas, just, you know, throw them at me. But that led me to listening to this. Chocolate Watch Band, The Inner Mystique. Ooh, this album is so good. Side one is kind of like the longer, more instrumental stuff, which is all good. But side two starts out with I'm Not Like Everybody Else, probably my favorite Chocolate Watch Band song. Medication's great. Let's Go, isn't that great? Baby Blue's great. And then probably my other favorite Chocolate Watch Band song ends with I Ain't No Miracle Worker. Just amazing. I like this more than their first. I have their first on CD. I like this more than their first. I haven't listened to their third one. It has like some picture of an eagle. It's a real lame cover, but this is a really cool cover. Another Sundazed reissue from 2009. This is pretty readily available still. I got this for $20. So yeah, Chocolate Watch Band. I've been listening to a lot of, I mean, you know, if you watch this channel, I show mainly punk, I'd say, new wave, power pop, whatever. But I've been listening to a lot of 60s lately, and I've probably listened to specifically side two of this about four times this week. This is the Yardbirds' greatest hits, and side one is great. But side two, I'm a Man, and then my favorite Yardbirds song, Happening 10 Years Time Ago. And then Heart Full of Soul, the live version of Smokestack Lightning. And then I'm Not Talking. Amazing. I would say Happening 10 Years Time Ago and their cover of Train Kept a Rollin' are my two favorite Yardbird songs. That's probably the only thing that could make this comp better. And I'd actually say switch it out with For Your Love. I like For Your Love, but compared to everything else on this album, it's just, it doesn't really hold a candle. This is one of those electronically rechanneled for stereo, one of those fake stereo things. Some of the songs sound a little muffled, yeah, it's a good, affordable way to get a lot of these songs. Yeah, Yardbird's Greatest Hits. And I was listening to a lot of singles. I'll just show you a couple of these. The Weeds, It's Your Time. Great Psych Garage from all over the place. But the kind of band leader and singer, Fred Cole, was from Oregon. He was in this band. Then he was in the King Bees, the Rats, Dead Moon, Pierce Darrow's, so many bands. This is really great. This is a reissue from, I want to say, like 1989. It has an insert, and they explain the insert as actually a interview with Fred that they conducted over the mail. They explain that they couldn't find the master tapes, so it's just basically a recording from the best possible copy they could find, which is pretty funny. This is really, let me play some of this, and then I'll just kind of show you some of the other singles I've been listening to. So hold on. Anyway, yeah, that single is amazing. Let me show you some of the other albums. I gotta show this first. This was, I don't know, I'm normally not in the mood for this, Daniel Johnston, Welcome to My World. This is basically like a best of comp. It has stuff from like 83, from his first album up until he passed away. That single is so good. Let me take that off. This has like Casper the Friendly Ghost, Man Obsessed, Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Your Grievances, Story of an Artist, Ain't No Woman Gonna Make a George Jones Out of Me. Just lo-fi songwriter, you know. Go listen to Daniel Johnston if you haven't heard. I'm sure most of you have, but I like Daniel Johnston a lot. But I really have to be in the right mood for this. And he's one of those artists where so much of his stuff is the same that I don't feel the need to like get every single album. I'm content with just this. So the last two, are punk records, which is what I normally show, as I'm sure you know if you watch this regularly. Oh, hold on. I was going to show this. I didn't have enough time to show this in my last vinyl finds, because I mean, it's not vinyl. But I bought this collection on it was very cheap. It was like $5 without, I mean, not including shipping, of all these Elvis Costello ads that someone had clipped out of magazines. They're really cool. Elvis Costello playing His Way, Our Way. Mime Is True. This one's got Tom Petty on the back. This one is Mime Is True, Buy It. And then it's, this one's really cool because on the back is an article about the punk band The Boys. I love that band. And then this one I don't really like. It's a caricature of him. And it's not that cool. But the one that I was kind of bought the lot for that I'd like to get framed. And all of these I'd seen before except for this one. I've never seen this before. Elvis Costello Goofing Off Takes Guts. And it was before the album came out. So the article underneath just talks about the Allison and Less Than Zero singles. Obviously, outtake photos from the Mime's True sessions. I don't think I've ever seen this photo before either. So I was really excited about that one. I'd like to get that framed. And then the back... How to Make Others Secretly Do Your Bidding, The Astonishing Power of Automatic Mind Control. It's kind of funny. So anyway, that was my tidbit of Elvis Costello memorabilia for you. I feel like I show some of that like every single video. But anyway, I was talking about, oh yeah, I watched the Johnny Thunders documentary last night, Finding Johnny. And I don't have any dolls or, solo Johnny Thunders or anything like that. And I don't even have LAMF, but I do have, the Yonkers demos. And, this has, I mean, some of these versions, I have listened to LAMF. It's just, I haven't found a reissue out in the wild yet. And, some of these versions are better than the album versions. The version of I Want to Be Loved on here, the version of Can't Keep My Eyes on You, the version of Flight. Then you get a couple different takes of some Richard Hell songs. You get Love Comes in Spurts and Blank Generation, two different takes of those. The first take of Love Comes in Spurts, it's almost like, it's a lot different. It's almost like a rockabilly number. Pirate Love, it's just amazing. Hurt Me is great. The whole thing is awesome. I'm almost rather listen to this than LAMF. This is on, Cleopatra. I think it's the second issue of this. I think it first came out, well, it was first bootlegged, and then it came out in 2019, and then this is the 2021 reissue. And then it's been reissued again in 2023. But this was recorded in 76. And Richard Hell on bass and vocals. Johnny Thunders on guitar and vocals. Walter Lure on guitar and vocals. And then Jerry Nolan on drums. So yeah, this is just mind-blowingly basic, but good. I'm not trying to say that they're... Basic's not a bad thing. I don't mean it like that, but you get some cool pictures on here. Everything on this inner sleeve talks about them performing at CBGB's or CBGB, but it seemed like they were more of a Max's band from the documentary at least. But it's kind of funny. It shows them with the Tough Darts opening for him that I just showed in the last vinyl finds. So yeah, and that led me to the last thing I played, which I mean, you know it, you love it. Blank Generation. Probably two of the greatest punk songs of all time. Love Comes in Spurts and the title track. But New Pleasure might be my favorite other than those two songs. Liars Beware, Betrayal Takes Two, Down at the Rock and Roll Club, Walking on Water, The Plan. The only song I'm not keen on is the last track on the album, Another World. It's just kind of jammy and goes on too long. It's just kind of, it's 8 minutes long. I mean, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, even 6 to 8 minutes, no. It's just too long. There's a couple songs that don't really, like, Who Says? I can't even recall how that sounds. But other than those two songs, this album's great. I did, like, a top 10 albums of 77 quite a while. That video sucked. Don't watch it. But I put this too low. I put this way too low. Yeah, this is great. So, Richard Hell and the Voidoids, obviously a reissue. You got a Marky back there. This back cover always kind of weirded me out because it's like, you know, these three guys look like they're in a punk band. And then this dude over here just looks like some hipster guy that you'd see in Seattle. It's like he's got a tear on his shirt. And then other than that, you know, he looks like he could be an REM or something. I don't know. But yeah, great album. So that's what I played. If you have any more, if you have any video ideas, tell me. So anyway, yeah. Thanks for putting up with me for 15, 20 minutes. Thanks for watching. Bye.